MIDI to give them the tool set to kind of the building blocks to build their own sound that is, you know, derived off of my sound, but has influences like from Daft Punk and The Weeknd and all these sounds. And if they feel like this dude provided lots of value and he gave me so much value up front and I kind of worked out with the loops, but I want something bigger, then I walk them through an email automation, mm-hmm. which is like I first give them the time capsule, then I give them a small little video on how to work with the time capsule, then I improve that and show them how to create a, you know, basic song out of these loops and give them more information on what is a timeless sound, like how do I approach timeless productions, and they watch it, and by the end they can decide to get on a call with me where I can help them produce out their demo with their, you know, what I gave them. Maybe they just use one loop, but it's like, you know, still fits into the whole vision.
It's the starter, you know, like the sourdough starter, you know, if someone's making bread, you know.
The kombucha starter.
Exactly, yeah.
Same thing. That's like one little thing. And once you have the algorithm down, once you refine it to a point where it actually works, then you need to scale it. And scaling, not in a sense where like hire a bunch of people, unless that's what you want, or like expand to a bigger studio and make it like the Walmart of music production, which, you know, I don't want that. But just amplify that with retargeting, you know, just retarget and add and get more people through the funnel, unless you got the amount and the quality of clients on a frequent basis, on a stable basis, which granted don't have yet to the point where I'm like super comfortable, but I know exactly what I need to do. That's clear. And I know that it's going to happen at some point. I'm just not there yet. I haven't done the actual steps.
Yeah, it's like kind of like how you were saying. It's like, don't give up on step number two. You got to go through all the motions and do all the work.
The other thing is, I don't have anything else. Like, making it work means not having, burning the boats. This is all very vague again. Like, you hear our, like, gurus, not that I'm a guru, but, like, you hear people talk about all the time, like, Gary Vee, like, you need to burn the boats, whatever. But for me, it's actually that. Like, I don't have anything else. Like, I only have this, and I have to make it work. And it might be at the cost of my freaking mental health, my physical health to an extent as well. But that's life again. Like, if you think about how my parents worked in fucking Kazakhstan, or like people 100 years ago, you know, you didn't have the luxury to be like, oh, this is hurting my mental health, I cannot do it. Of course, you got to be mindful because you want to do this for the next 10, 15, 20 years, as long as you can. And you want to make it as comfortable, like do the actual steps. And you know, sometimes you get to sacrifice something. So I don't have anything else in my life that.
Yeah, you're making me think of like the immigrants in New York from, you know, the Jews from like, you know, the Ukraine that moved to New York in the early 1900s.
And right.
You
just
know,
got to hustle it out. This is why I'm like, hustled, I don't want to do anything else. Like, I don't want to do anything else. This is why I picked this shit and I can't. I mean, technically, of course, I could find some freaking job and work at it, but like, do I want it? It's like, ugh. No. So I don't have anything else, honestly.
Yeah. Totally. I got to do what you got to do. I'd like to actually shift topics for a little bit because one of the main reasons I brought you back on the show is I am curious about your approach to mixing inside of Ableton, because so many people are like, oh yeah, I want to check out Ableton, but I'm so comfortable in Pro Tools. Or people are like, I love Ableton, but like I can't mix in it because the way, you know, the auxiliary channels work is completely different. It's not the way, you know, it's like, you know, Pro Tools or Logic can make it work. Like, how do you mix inside of Ableton? And maybe you could walk people through like at least a basic setup of how you get mixes going.
Easily.
Go for it.
I don't know. Like, I don't see the difficulty. It's just a matter of being used to it, I guess. Like, I used to mix on Logic Pro. I still have it for certain tasks sometimes. But just the way stuff works in Ableton Live, it's just fast. Like, it's fast, it's direct. And where in Logic you would need 5 steps to, you know, flex an audio and vary speed, whatever. In Ableton, you have put the audio, click on the audio, click on warping, and usually that's it, unless you have to adjust the tempo. And you can pitch it up and speed it up and down, the BPM, easily. That's as far as production goes. As far as mixing goes, since they added comping takes I'm done. Like, I'm settled. That was the only thing that was missing, is comping vocals and instruments and choosing the best takes out of a bunch. Actually, I don't even do that. I have, like, I outsource my vocal stuff to a guy in Russia, actually, to a vocal engineer. So he does all the melodining, vocal lining, whatever I need. So I only get the vocal spec done, and I only mix, you know, the rest and put my flavor to it. Which is, again, one more lesson right here, is I stopped doing that. Anything that I don't like to an extent, I know
that you're like the 4-hour work week. Yes, in real life.
I do actually want to work 4 days a week, not more than that. I'm striving for that long term. I don't see the point in the whole hustling until you're dead. I like it. I enjoy it, but like that's not what life is about. Anyways,
Yeah, totally.
That's a luxury, and I'm still not perfect again. You know, like, I stopped doing anything that I don't like and stopped working at all. Like, no. But like, you know, you just try to create circumstances and then algorithms.
Right.
You talked about
delegation.
Exactly.
And you talked about,
exactly,
you know, cutting things out.
And avoiding stuff that you actually, I work only online. You know, I work on my terms. I outsource vocal mixing. That stuff, you know, that makes
I
it
cut
easier.
Out Facebook. I cut out Twitter. Like,
exactly.
All those things.
Exactly.
So, but anyways, as you were with Ableton.
Exactly. Once they implemented that, I'm pretty cool. What's super dope about Ableton, and like, makes mixing super fast, are racks. I know Logic has like macros and all that shit, and Studio One as well, bunch of other DAWs. But the way it works in Ableton with the new updated racks, you can just chain a bunch of stuff together and put macros on, save it, and just do it. I have like rack for vocal mixing where you have like 8-7 plugins in a chain that are just thrown on the main vocal, and that's okay for mastering as well, if I do the mastering at all. So racks is super fast, but also parallel processing, which is, you can take a track and you can just group basically any plugin. You press Command and G and it groups, and then you can split it, which you can duplicate a chain inside a track, which allows me to do parallel processing without using sands or buses or whatever. You can create a bus if you want to, but I can just, you know, take a track, group any plugin, and then it creates a chain, which is like just splits the signal in two. And then
I think Studio One does this also.
Maybe. I haven't known of Studio One in a long time.
Yeah. But just, I mean, I'm not even thinking about getting Studio One, but yeah.
One thing, it's heavy on a CPU, because Ableton does similar stuff to other DAWs where it taxes the cores of your CPU per track. So if I put like 7 plugins on one track, it doesn't distribute these plugins between cores. It just loads it onto one core. Like one track, one core. It doesn't matter like how many cores your CPU has. If you have like 12 cores, fuck you. Like it depends on your one core strength. So you have to freeze stuff sometimes, where you just need to freeze and flatten the track, or just freeze it and make it inactive, especially for vocals if you have like super elaborate parallel chains. But the quality I get out of parallel processing, sometimes even on a master, which is like, oh, doesn't it fuck around with the phase of the track? Sometimes it does, but it's not to a point where it's like audible. You know, I'm not mixing, you know, pristine jazz, whatever, every day for the music that I mix.
You can get away with a little bit of dirty, you know, with that.
And then sometimes you just have a, you know, mastering chain, and you put a parallel EQ with a smile curve on it, and you just boost it in slowly, and it lifts the lows and the highs, and it just adds like a weight and a sheen that's usually not attainable with other tools. At least I don't know how to do it in anything else. And it's fast. You save it, you just do whatever, I just type in like Command F for search bar, vocal mixing, and then my chain pops up, and I drop it on the track, and then I, you know, fuck around and adjust to taste, and it works, and parallel, because parallel processing is the secret to great mixes. You know, not only dry wetting stuff, but actually parallel processing stuff, like aggressive drums, vocals that pop in your face, huge like stacks of synths that you glue together, and they have like this quality to them where just the attack is like popping in your face. You only get that shit with like really good parallel processing for the most part, along other things. And this is what's getting me
your good results in Ableton.
Fast from A to B in Ableton Live.
Wow, so cool. I love how you just have like the, okay, this is the preset. Da-da-da. Let me just tweak it till it works. It sounds like the rack is almost like a VCA or like a, or maybe like a track stack inside of Logic. I'm not totally sure. But it's kind of like a, it's kind of like an auxiliary.
Not exactly. It's like you have the same thing in Logic where it's channel strip presets. Channel strips where you just save a bunch of plugins in a certain configuration and you can load them up instantly onto the track as a chain. But in Ableton, they're grouped within the channel. You can group them within the channel and you can map each and every parameter to a macro. And then, you can even set like minimum and maximum values for the macro as well. So, you can turn the macro from 0 to 100, but then on the EQ, it only goes from like 20 hertz to 80 hertz for the low cut only and not the entire range. So you can tweak that, for example.
Wow. So it's like a totally customizable.
Exactly. The colors, the names, the ranges, everything super customizable. You got like, now with Ableton 11, you get a huge, like twice the amount of banks on for like the values, the knobs.
So the one thing that I think it seems to be what people struggle with is like auxiliary sends and stuff. So you're, what you're doing inside of Ableton is like,
honestly,
everything is on
the track.
I don't
even use sends at all.
Right, everything is like wet dry with like a reverb or something on that channel.
That's where the parallel chains come in. If I need a reverb on the main vocal, I can use like, I like Little Plate from Sound Toys for like a plate sound on send A and send from the main one. I can do that as well. But I can also just group a utility and just create a second channel, put a Little Plate on it, 100% wet, and then maybe put a low cut behind, put some saturation or bit crusher for color, and then just balance out the loudness of the both change. They're like both at 0 dB, and then you just adjust the second one -20, and then it's just that. It's basically dry wetting, but with like more flexibility.
Huh. Interesting.
And I don't have phase issues at all. I don't know where people get it from. Sometimes you might get some weird phasing, but if you use, I don't know, reverb, delay, it doesn't even matter. You don't hear like actual like chorusing where it's like a phaser where you get, phase cancellation. I don't get that very often. On drums.
No, I mean, your mixes sound so I would say that your mixes sound clean. Listening to, your the things that I've heard, super clean, if anything. So maybe Ableton's just the processing under the hood is just super smooth. I don't know.
Maybe. Well, it has some problems as any DAW. The other thing, while like Rex, is when I get projects from other people or I work with other people in other DAWs, be it like, especially Logic. Logic is very clunky about automation, in my opinion. Like, it's very clunky in terms of like, you gotta open up the automation lane and then you gotta pick the parameter and then just, automate the right way, and then you have like latch, write, read. You don't have that on Ableton at all. And what I like is Ableton has also these DJ style racks, which I build myself as well. I have like this, by the way, if you want to have couple dope racks, you can go to my website, which is thefunklore.com, and then you can go to the Time Capsule tab. You can download, it's called the Time Capsule, and then you have three racks in it, which is Funk Filters, Parallel Verb Transition, and I forgot the third one, but it's basically racks, stock plugins grouped together, them together in a certain way where you can only move one knob and it gives like crazy, you get chain of effects for transitions. And that's missing in a lot of stuff. Ableton guys, our transitions are on point. Like the automation, the way the song progresses, and that's everything. Like if the song doesn't catch my ear and it's not carrying me from bar 8 to 16 to 32, whatever, I'm going to skip it. So this is very important. And Logic guys, for the most part, unless you're a Disclosure, lots of guys missing that, the transitional part, which is mostly automation, the movement.
Interesting.
And enable life, you have racks and you automate like a reverb on an element with a low cut where it just transitions. It doesn't have to be super DJ style over the top, like, super right. crazy
But you're using those macros and it just makes it all super fast.
You don't have like Endless Smile is one plugin that does that. If you know that Endless Smile is one plugin.